Thank you, Dr. Quiroz. Yes.
Okay, so my turn. I'm very happy to be here at Delphi Economic Forum for the first time, so I'm pleased to have the floor. And I'd like to take the topic from a rather different angle. The question which was given to us is how can we restore trust between the citizens for the elites who have been doing the European Union? And going back to what Peter Spiegel said at the last panel here, I would like to strengthen that every poll is indicating to us that the confidence into the European Union is gone, but not the trust into Europe. And so we should very much distinguish, when we are talking about what is the future of Europe, we should distinguish between the European Union as of today and Europe, because there's a lot of trust in Europe. There's not much trust left into the EU after the crisis we had. So if the question is, how can we restore trust? I give you three answers. And I'm very sorry to say that none of them has to do with growth. This is the Delphi Economic Forum, but I want to do other arguments, and these arguments are all about sovereignty, and the arguments are about democracy, which is the beast we are looking for. So how can we restore trust? I give you three answers. Let the citizen decide. Second answer, make Europe social and democratic. And third answer, make the citizens the sovereign of the system. The real problem of the European Union today is that the citizens are not in decision and the citizens are not the sovereign. What I mean is that we tend to believe that the nation state is the sovereign or the European is the sovereign, but none of them are the sovereign. Between sovereign is only the citizen. So sovereignty is always emanating from the citizens, and that is why we have all these disputes today, for instance, between the European Union, who wants a distribution key for refugees, and Orban is not wanting that key. And so what we are not having in Europe today is basically Max Weber legitimate monopoly of power. We do not know who decides in Europe, and that is the European problem. So if we want to answer that, the answer is not that we do need a European superstate, but what we do need is parliamentarization, full parliamentarization of the system and division of power. None of them have to do with superstate ambitions, but they have to do with democracy, division of power and parliamentarization. And this is actually what we are discussing when we are talking about the Macron plans, when we are talking about the Eurozone government, when we are talking about the European finance minister, about the Euro budget, whatever. We are basically talking about the elements of legitimacy of a different Europe, which is fully parliamentarized and which has division of power, which are two features that the current European Union does not offer us today. I turn the argument around in a quite different way. What we are searching for is, after that we achieved one market and then one currency, what we are searching now for is the one democracy, and that was also what has been discussed in the panel before when we were searching for the beast of European democracy. So what is one democracy? I offer you one simple definition of what a democracy is, and that is the necessary though not sufficient condition. And that condition is that the citizens of that democracy are equal in front of the law. We, as European citizens, we are not. We are the French or the Finns or the Slovenes or the Greeks, and we are not equal in front of the law. We do have different voting systems, we do have different tax systems, we do have different social systems, and that is basically the essence of the crisis, because we go into national competition for national economic advantages, and we do not respect the very necessary basis for one democracy if we are striving for a European democracy, which is that all European citizens should be equal in perspective in front of the law. By the way, this was granted already in the Maastricht Treaty. I'm not talking about utopian things. The Maastricht Treaty 92 regulates we are union of states and we are union of citizens. The real fact is we never became union of citizens in the sense of one democracy and of one European citizenship with a normative underpinning. So what I'm coming to is, if we had that, which is equality in front of the law, basically, we would be in the process of European nation-making. I give you one definition of a French sociologue, which is called Marcel Mauss. He has a very interesting definition of what makes a nation. His definition is, what makes a nation is instituted solidarity. So solidarity is not an arbitrary choice and not a random choice of some Bundestag decisions whether we grant the Greeks of a third or fourth bailout. But it is institutionalized solidarity, and those who are in a system of institutionalized solidarity, where the solidarity is not put into question, but legiferated, these people are in a nation. What the definition gives us is that nation is not about culture, ethnics, about language, but a nation is about a process of legiferation and of convergence of law systems. And so here's my very pragmatic suggestion how we can restore trust for the citizens and go for a different level of European democracy, which is that having, I repeat, after having done one market and one currency, and the euro was nothing else than the legal convergence of a currency, we did basically one euro, we did then one IBAN number for the whole European system. What we should do now to express the equality of the law of all European citizens is we should be striving for a European social security number for all European citizens. We can give us some time. I had the enormous chance to work for Jacques Delors in the 90s. He gave it 10 years to make the euro. We could give it 15 years to make a European social security number. Say we converge for the 1st of January 2030. We can fix the date, but it was a process of harmonization of law that brought us into the euro and that made us one market and then one currency. And if we want to have one democracy, that is the process to be heading for now. So I finish with Sieto I Europaika Demokratio. That is what I have been taught. It would mean in Greece, one European democracy. Thank you for the audience.